You can think of it like a mountain that's been dormant for far too long. And eventually it's bound to erupt.
That's a D plus revolution. I like it. I like it very much. Do you want me to call you Esperanza or Emily?
You can call me Emily.
Because for this entire project, you're going to be working that incredible bass. And I've never seen you look so beautiful when you're able to actually carry the bass around plugged in. It's fantastic.
Yeah, that doesn't matter though. We're talking about D plus evolution, and that's an important concept to me. So it seemed that all the parts that go along with this project are just the ones that added to getting that concept across. So I'm not really thinking about the bass or any of that, but the D plus evolution part is an important instrument in this project.
When you say that it's a volcano that's about to explode, is any of that personal?
I think that's universal, you know. We all have facades that we operate from within, and this is a space where we get to pretend to be a new part of ourselves. So it's the concept of pretending to be more yourself.
It's fantastic. There's a wonderful story about you that you were watching television. Yo-Yo Ma, I believe, is on Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. Mm-hmm. And you decide that you want to be a musician at that point in your life. Mm-hmm. Were you able to perform with Yo-Yo Ma? Was there ever a time?
No, but I would say that that piece of my history is about as relevant as whatever happened to you 25 years ago.
So you know what? It's all relevant.
It's all relevant.
Because and I wouldn't be able to make transformations without it.
That's true. And Yo-Yo Ma doesn't have a lot to do with this project, I'm going to tell you the truth. But he's wonderful, and he's a glorious human being.
All right. Then I'll ask you, when Emily is back in town, what is she going to do?
She is going, I am going to be performing at the Crystal Ballroom. And I don't know when we're going to be back in town, but we will be back in town because as some of you here, I don't know who's here, but no, everybody in my home still calls me Emily. They didn't ever make the transition to my first name, which is Esperanza. So when I come home, I feel more like Emily than anywhere else.
That's fantastic.
And I'm sure that Emily will be touching home base many, many more times.
Do you see any people from the Conservancy here or any old friends in the audience when you come
to town? No, none of my friends will be coming to my shows. Just kidding. No, I just can't see who's here, but I'm sure there's somebody.
All right. Because these are kind of your disciples for this project, and they want to obviously go tell their friends about it, mm-hmm. How would you have them best described what the D-plus revolution is about?
It's D-plus evolution. I look at it like either the space where devolution and evolution are mutually informative, because we don't necessarily evolve forward. You know, we don't know which way evolution is going. We don't even know which way time is going. Mm. So it's this idea that progress is a combination of going backwards and going forwards. Like we're digging in things, like you said, from our past as well as projecting into the future. Or you could also look at like, you have to evolve no matter what happens in your life. Circumstances change and you have to engage with your new reality. And when I was a kid, I always had really bad grades. Like I don't think I ever really had an A or A+. So I also look at it like a D plus in evolution. You only get a D plus, but you still have to move forward even if you don't, quote unquote, have all the tools you need. And I really identify with that of the what it requires to engage with the unexpected when you're not, quote unquote, fully prepared with your strategy. I think that's where the most exciting creativity happens. So that's kind of what we're talking about.
Well, I was not prepared today, obviously, to talk to Emily. And so I'm thrilled to learn more about this project, especially just to hear your music. It's fantastic. Let's get more music from Esperanza Spalding presents Emily's D plus evolution.
Thank you.
Now, of course, after a song like that, we're going to talk about Judas, okay? And not just that one historical Judas. Many, 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 many Judases there are, aren't there? And specifically, we want to talk about the man-made Judases. Oh, yeah. Raised to worship and follow the holy ideals of society. Yet due to man-made circumstances, ultimately destined to betray them.
Man, 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 won't lose you.
broke down. Now he's a shadow made for the modern world. My mind, but if you ask my advice, us raging. Ask my advice, there are decades won't hold the rising sea of raging zombie. A matter of time, money, good money made in the street. It's not evil. We're also going to talk about love, that all-forgiving, all-healing force, right? And specifically, if we really want to talk about love, and if we really want to be love and live love, it's got to be unconditional. Can't be any masks or costumes or acts, and that's very hard to do. But we're going to do it right here with you. Because I think we can do it. I think we're grown up and we've been through enough of the other stuff to know. So, we can change that whole story of love. Same old play I'm getting tired of. No more acting these predictable roles. Just a sleeping unconditional. Cliches and makeup, dancing and singing.
story of a love. Say more play, I'm getting tired of no more acting these predictable roles. Just a sleepy, unconditional love. We could change that whole story of a love. Say more play.
Play, I'm getting tired of it. Just get to the
Just a sleeping.